It's absolute insanity. We must speak up. If we want reform, if we want healthcare to be fair, if we want it to be just, we must speak up. Doctors must speak up. Patients must speak up. So in my ongoing saga with health insurance companies, so horrible, horrible institutions, I'd like to add Fidelis Care to the list of shit vile health insurance companies. So for those of you who aren't aware, Fidelis Care is a local New York-based insurance company. It's not for profit, but somehow their CEO, who's a reverend, makes $5.5 million a year. I don't know how that works out. But anyways, let me get to the meat of this story. So a patient of mine who has vitiligo, I've been seeing him since 2019. We've been treating him with laser treatments for his vitiligo over the course of the last nearly 2 years. It's been a year and three quarters. After having treated him for nearly a year and three quarters, Fidelis is trying to recoup payments for over 100 treatments. And let me go back to where this all started. So knowing how insurance companies work, before we even touch a patient, before we even look at a laser, we call the insurance company to make sure the patient has benefits that cover this treatment. So we verify benefits, and in this particular case, we spoke to Rich at Fidelis Care back on July 29th of 2019, and we said, Rich, our patient has your insurance, he needs laser treatments for vitiligo, is this a covered procedure? Rich said, yes, it's a covered procedure, no prior authorization is required, you're good to go. Over the course of the last year and three quarters, we've been treating our patient, we've been submitting our claims, we've been getting paid without issue. No problems at all. So obviously we assumed everything is good to go. We're covered. We don't need any authorizations. The care is covered. We're getting paid. All good. Somehow a month ago, we get a denial saying this treatment requires a prior authorization. So for a year and a half, no prior authorizations required. Rich at Fidelis Care said no prior authorizations required. We're submitting payments and we're getting paid, obviously indicating that no prior authorizations required. But somehow for this particular treatment in April, prior authorization was required. So we contacted Fidelis, said, hey, something seems off here. You know, we've been treating this patient without issue, yada, yada, yada. They said, well, you know what? Send all the notes for this patient. So we did. We complied. We, you know, with whatever they needed. We sent notes, probably, I don't know, 50, 100 notes, whatever they asked for. And they came back at us and said, well, you know what? We never should have paid you for any of these treatments. And now you need to pay us back for all of the payments that we made to you. I mean, think about that. We've been treating this patient for a year and three quarters. We've cured him of his condition. And Fidelis is now trying to recoup all of those payments over the course of the last year and three quarters. I mean, that's entrapment. They basically entrapped me, tricked me into treating a patient, saying, hey, this is covered, all good. Your time, we're going to pay you for your time. We're going to pay you for the laser treatments, which are very expensive. The lasers cost hundreds of thousands of dollars. I mean, it's not like cheap devices. And now after having cured the patient, they're saying, oh, no, no, we never should have paid you. Now you have to pay us back. That's the way they're profitable. They're basically entrapping doctors into treating patients, and then we have to recoup, they're trying to recoup the payment, so the patient essentially gets treated for free, gets cured for free. The insurance company doesn't have to pay anything out of the pocket. We're not gonna make our poor patient have to pay for that. I mean, poor guy, you know, he has insurance. The insurance company said they're gonna pay for it, so he's kind of out of the picture. So now it's between the doctor and the insurance company, who they entrapped to treat their patient for a year and a half, and now are trying to recoup payments. I mean, it is a totally disgusting, vile operation. It's up to doctors. So I know a lot of you doctors out there have been DMing me and telling me about similar situations that you've had with various health insurance companies, Fidelis and United included, but no one seems to be speaking up about it. And I don't know why that is. Doctors must speak up about this. Patients must also speak up about this. It's up to us, doctors and patients, who are both getting royally screwed by these disgusting, vile health insurance companies. It's off of our backs, off of patients' backs, off of doctors' backs, that insurance companies can be profitable enough, a not-for-profit insurance company can be profitable enough to pay its CEO $5.5 million a year. It's absolute insanity. We must speak up. If we want reform, if we want healthcare to be fair, if we want it to be just, we must speak up. Doctors must speak up. Patients must speak up. Let's get it.